Hey everybody, this is a demonstration of one of our first projects where we are going to import a DXF pattern. A DXF pattern is basically just a flat 2D pattern. Lots of people will draft patterns, you know, in all kinds of different types of software besides CLO, and they'll save it as DXF AAMA. And it's a universal way to read patterns. So right now I'm on this website where you can actually get free DXF patterns here. You can also get them as PDFs as well. Or you can spend like $2 to $3 for all these other choices, and you could type in your own measurements. And this is a really affordable resource if, you know, you need a quick pattern maker to kind of get started instead of you having to draft patterns from scratch. But anyways, if you work in the industry, you'll notice, you'll be working with DXF patterns coming from your factories most likely. So it's just a very common format. So it's a really good assignment that we get to learn how to import one of those into CLO. And then once we have our 2D pattern though, we need to figure out how to place those pattern pieces on the avatar, which leads me to believe we need to know how to import an avatar and make sure the avatar is the correct size as our fit model. And then we need to figure out how to sew those pattern pieces together so we can see what it looks like on the avatar. Okay, so let's get started. So for this assignment, I gave you a pattern to download, the DXF pattern. We're all gonna use the same one. So you'll go ahead and go to CLO. And let's see here, why don't we go ahead and just import the pattern? So we'll go up to File. So when we're adding patterns, there's more than one way to do it. So we're not gonna do file add because this is adding like a CLO specific file. You can save patterns in CLO, but this isn't a CLO pattern. It's a DXF, it's a universal one. So we're not gonna go to add. We're gonna keep cruising down, and we're gonna go to import. You can either one, at this case doesn't matter because it's our first one. Maybe just get in the habit of doing import and add. And there it is. That's the file type we want, is DXF. And as you can see, there's also PDF files too, if somebody sent you a PDF file. But DXF is the standard. So let's do that. Now a window should pop up, and you're just gonna have to go and find where you saved that pattern. So I actually have two. Let's see, well, let me do both of them at the same time. Looks like you can only add one at a time. So I'll go ahead and say click open. All of this, I'm just gonna say okay. Okay, and we have it added in, great. Okay, so now we're gonna go ahead and load up the other one, file, import. This time we want to add it. We don't want to replace the original one. We're adding a second pattern. And we're going to add the bottom. And I'll just say okay. Great. Okay, so now we need our fit model, our avatar. So to do that, it will be in the library. If you don't see your library, it might be hiding over here, but click library. We're just going to use CLO's default avatars. So double click avatar. Today we're going to do female version 2, and you can actually choose from any of them. I don't really care which one. I'm just picking the top because that's the easiest. Okay. So here's the avatar, but we're going to actually change her size at this point. So there's a folder here that says size. I'm going to double click that guy. And today we're going to do, these are some standard measurement charts. We're going to do Missy Curvy, and we're just going to do the smallest one, size 2. So all I did was double clicked it, and my computer's thinking, and voila, she's shorter, she's smaller, she is now curvy, size 2. Okay. Another thing you may want to do too as we're doing this, and maybe we can do it a little bit later if it's distracting, I'm going to double click this folder, double click to go back, is that there's texture. So, and then we're in the first one. So right now she has like a little black, like little underwear set on. You'll be able to see that through the bikini, which kind of like takes away from the design. So you can actually double click and, oops, actually just kidding. Okay, you'll click the avatar and then you're gonna go down and look for texture, and then you can click those little boxes. Okay, let's see here. And actually, I'm gonna say cancel. Let's click, I think I clicked the wrong box. Oh, funny. Okay, I'll say cancel. I'm gonna try to click, drag, and drop and bring it over here. Okay, there we go, and it worked. That time I just clicked, dragged, and brought it over there. Sometimes I will open the window and it'll be there. That's so funny, I just did this like 5 minutes ago. Oh, here, now it is now. I clicked it and it has all the different choices. Nude or covered or whatever. If it's distracting to have her nude, you know, while you're working, you can obviously go back to covered. But yeah, so anyways, there's two ways to do it. See how it works on your computer. If just clicking this box works for you, if you're having trouble with that, you should be able to click, drag, and drop and put it in there as well. So, okay, so I'm just going to go ahead right now. And same with the shoes. You guys could really have a lot of fun. Like, does she need to be wearing high heels right now? Let me go here. Oops. Let me go back to avatar, female two, shoes, you know, all these great choices here. But anyways, okay. Let's get back. That is not part of the assignment. I'm just getting completely distracted. Okay, so let's focus now. So we have our pattern. We imported a DXF pattern. That's an amazing skill to know how to do. So congratulations, we did that. We opened the avatar. We changed the size of the avatar. One other thing I'd like to speak to regarding changing the size of the avatar is that it's so great to just use those standard measurement charts. That's a great way to go. But if you are working on a specific customer whose measurements, you know, I mean, I don't think anybody's measurements are going to match the standard chart perfectly. Like, we're all a little different here and there. So if you have like one customer and you want to get it to match perfect, you can actually go up to avatar and choose avatar editor. And in this window, you have the ability to type in specific measurements. So I'm on the first tab that says avatar size. And, you know, maybe, oh, you know, I like to work in inches though. So I'm going to switch from millimeter to inches. Okay, so, you know, maybe the bust is 33 inches, like the size, but, you know, maybe the waist is actually 26 inches, not 25.3. So you could actually just type in that measurement and it'll save it for you and change the avatar. So that's kind of neat. We don't need to do that today, but I just want to bring that to your attention since we're kind of on topic. Okay, so our next thing is we need to place all these pattern pieces on the avatar, roughly where they go. Okay, so in CLO, we have the arrangement tool. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn that on. And let's see here. You know what? I think for these three, I'll start with the bottoms. I'm gonna select all three of those. I didn't get the last one. So I'm gonna hold shift and grab it. And then I'm just gonna, maybe I'll just scooch it out of the way for a second. I'm just gonna pick this button, that little blue dot. And all I did, I hovered over the blue dot and I clicked it one time with my mouse. Okay, I'm gonna do the back. And here's a great time to use your keyboard shortcuts. I'm gonna hit the number 8, and that brings me to the back. And all I gotta do is just click that little blue dot, and it's right in the right spot. Okay, while I'm on the back, well, I guess I'll just go ahead and select all these. I should point out, I'm in the letter A, keyboard shortcut A tool. It selects our patterns, and I just clicked and dragged. And then now I'll just pick, I guess, this dot. Seems good. I'll hit the number 2. Boom, I'm in the front. Gosh, that one's actually pretty good where it's sitting. But maybe I'll just go ahead and use the arrangement points anyways. Okay, there we are. Okay. Oh, I didn't get those straps. I'm going to hit edit undo. I'm going to go ahead and see if I can also grab the straps. Okay. I don't know if that's going to mess me up or not. Because I only, there we go. Let's try this one more time. Okay, cool. Okay, that's a great. So now I can turn off my arrangement points. Fabulous. Now our next job is to sew this up. This is an excellent opportunity to practice the sewing tools. Here we have segment sewing. If I click and hold it, there's two options. We can just do one segment at a time, or we can do multiple segments at a time, which is kind of neat. The second sewing tool is our free sewing tool, and same thing. We can just do, you know, one seam at a time, or we can do like kind of multiple across ones. So it's really good to practice with these, continue to get more familiar with them. Okay, so maybe because it's easiest, I'll start with the bottom and I just need to sew these seams together. I think in this case, it's gonna be easiest to use our segment tool. So I'm gonna click, click. Notice how my notches are both at the top, or like in this case, they're both at the bottom. Okay, you just wanna make sure that they line up, otherwise your seam will get twisted. Okay, so just pay attention to those little notches. Here's our side seam, okay. I'm gonna zoom out and sew the other side seam. My notch is at the top there. There we go. Okay, here I'm gonna sew the bottom little crotch area. I don't think I need that segment point, so I'm gonna click the letter Z, and I'm gonna click it and delete. And I'm gonna go over to the other one and also delete it. Then I'm gonna go back to the sewing segment tool and I'll click. Okay, I have my notch kind of close to left side. Going in here and do the same thing. So the notch is close to where is left. Okay, I think that guy looks like he's sewn pretty good.